Knowledge is power.
Hey guys, what's up? GGNG here, and I'm going to do a test episode of a new series I'm thinking of doing. It's going to be A to Z replay analysis. We're going to look at the replays of the top players on Dotabuff for each hero, starting from Abaddon and going all the way down to Zeus. I'm going to take replays from like the top 20-ish or so players, and I'll pick one or two that I want to go over, and we'll see how each of them plays their hero. We'll look at item builds, skill builds, how to play effectively, just little tricks and tips, stuff like that. I don't want to take any replays from professional games, because I feel like the way that these heroes are played in real games are sort of vastly different from the way pub games go. So I'm only going to stick to pub matches for this series. I might do a professional match series if you guys want, but that'll come way later after I'm done with these. So we're gonna look at this Abaddon here. He is ranked number one on Dotabuff. He has something like an 80% win rate with the hero, like 200 games. And he's pretty high skill, I think. At least from what I can tell, he's at least 5k. He does play with a stack though, so that might contribute to his win rate. But if you have your Abaddon as your most played hero, and you win that much with him, I'm gonna guess you're pretty good with him. So I think this is a good replay to watch. And he also does play Abaddon as a support hero, which is pretty important. I don't wanna do a carry Abaddon replay because it probably inflates your hero score. And the most accepted way to play Abaddon is as a support. I don't think he's too effective as a carry. I'll do mostly replays that showcase the accepted role for each hero, but I might deviate for some heroes if I find their skill build or playstyle interesting. So I'm gonna just fast forward the replay until the game actually starts, and we'll look at the Abaddon starting items. Holy shit, this guy has a 35 win streak. Alright. So he goes TP, Tango, did he buy Courier? I think he bought Courier as well, and he got wards pulled to the offlaner. So the TP is pretty interesting already. This is something that, oh shit, this guy has a 52 win streak, okay. But yeah, the Abaddon got a TP scroll, and this is interesting already because I don't see anyone do this. I'm just guessing he's going to play like a Dazzle. So if he sees someone getting ganked at level 1, he can TP to the lane and drop a shield or a heal. He hasn't leveled up his first spell yet either, so we'll see what that's going to be. The Tango and Clarities, I think, are pretty standard. And that one branch, probably just to give him a bit more bulk. It might turn into a mech later, we'll see what items he goes. Alright, so he's gonna contest the rune with his team. I'm interested to see if he is gonna help zone at all. I'm gonna guess no, because Abaddon's a pretty crappy laner. Just gonna play defensive and pull is my guess. Alright, so he's looking around the map, it's pretty good, seeing if he needs a TP anywhere. And he's gonna pull this first wave probably. Against a centaur, I don't think he's gonna help zone at all. Alright, and he still hasn't leveled up his first skill yet, so we'll see what he does. He levels up his heal right here, actually. That's pretty interesting. I think the shield is usually the accepted first level. Oh, he actually uses the heal to pull through. Huh. I don't know if that's completely necessary, but I guess it's a pretty cool trick you can do. The cast range is actually quite long, and it does pull aggro pretty easily. So I guess that's a pretty neat thing to do if you have heal level 1. Missed a bit surprised because the shield is usually taken because it debuffs, and it's really useful for level 1. But I guess if you're just pulling, getting the heal is pretty good. Alright, so now that he's level 2, he's actually going to help zone the centaur. Oh, good shield. And he's gonna do some nice harass. That did push the lane a bit, as his shield popped on all the creeps. But they're doing a pretty good job zoning with his witch doctor. Alright, and he did get boots with his first, gold over time. So he's gonna go secure the rune, pop his clarity. I'm interested to see if he plays Abaddon as a 4 or a 5. I'm gonna guess he plays as a 5. But he did get boots before anything else, so maybe he does play as a 4. I think boots are pretty important to get early on Abaddon. It really does help you get in position better for healing and shielding. And he's probably gonna pull this next wave. We'll see what boots he upgrades into, but he is looking like he's gonna get the courier.
And the blood spills.
Blood. Have I got juice on my chains?
So, from what we can tell for the
Radiant's
first
top
few
tower is
minutes,
under siege.
it's mostly just gonna be pulling and looking around the map to see if you can help any of your lanes with a TP. Abaddon is sort of a really passive hero to begin with, so this is probably really good. And he is gonna get the courier right now. Sorry that I couldn't start on a more exciting hero, but I do want to just do this A to Z. Straight, organized, so you guys know what to expect. Right, so he did get heal at level 3, and I'm just gonna guess that he's gonna max heal by the way he's playing. Okay, so he is saving mana. Not gonna unnecessarily waste a shield, as you do only have 300 mana pool at the early levels. So he's gonna save his shield for when he really needs it. Oh, okay. He's gonna wait for the stun. It's pretty good. You always wanna wait for the stuns until and then cast your shield. And okay, so just going over that last fight, he waited for the stun to come out from the Wraith King, and then he shielded, which is something you should always do.
Denied.
You don't want to shield too early because the shield does debuff any stuns. I was sort of surprised that he didn't heal immediately, though. I guess he was trying to bait them into the tower, which is also a pretty good thing to do. But if he healed fast, I think the Kanka would have been alive for another heal at the end. He might have lived. But yeah, he is also getting no points in the passive. I see some Abaddons get a point into passive, and I do think that's incorrect. If you just look at what the passive gives you, it's 5% movement slow and attack speed slow, which is like nothing. That's worse than an Orb of Venom. And you get that 15% movement speed bonus, but I don't think it's worth not having a point in your heal or your shield. And he does pick up Tranquil Boots. I do like this choice. I think Arcane Boots are slowly becoming outdated on most heroes. The only reason you get them is for your team, most of the time. Tranquil Boots are just so much better for just sustain and just moving around. Oh, he's gonna run into three here. And I think he's dead. Well, apparently not. Okay, so let's see how he plays this. Because Abaddon's not really a good aggressive here. We'll see how he engages into fights instead of being engaged on. So nothing really happened there, unfortunately. Okay, so he is letting his other support do the warding. It sort of makes sense because Abaddon's not a ranged hero, so he has difficulty warding and dewarding. But he always could buy the wards and just give them to the Witch Doctor. And he's gonna go back and pull. I still haven't seen him use the TP yet. I don't think he's needed to, but it would be nice to see how he deals with counter ganking. And he always uses the heal to pull, or pull through. I guess this is one of those things that is slightly easier to pull off than actually drawing aggro at the right time. Okay, so since he is getting 4 position farm, all the pull camps, and he's not getting wards, we're gonna see what item he goes for. My guess is that it's probably an urn or a mechanism. And he's just staying behind his Ember Spirit. Oh, that's a mistake by the Centaur. I don't know why he did that. Alright, so his two Clarys actually lasted him until 9 minutes. I think that's just good mana management by the Abaddon. He never uses the spells for anything other than saving or going aggressive. Like, he knows there's a kill. So he's not spamming his shield on allies that aren't like in danger of dying. And he really only uses his heal outside of healing allies who are dying to pull. And it's only 70 mana right now, so it's pretty good. Ooh, he does save the bear, that's pretty cool. It dies anyway. That was a good effort by the Abaddon. Okay, and he's out of mana, so he's not gonna try to overextend himself. I think this is a... I don't know what's going on. Alright, that was just a huge overextension by Radiant. No idea what's happening. That's pretty good by the Abaddon. So he does get his ulti at 6. I've seen some Abaddons just go, like, super selfless 4400 by level 8. But I guess getting his ulti is the way to go. I do think so too. It just makes you super annoying in early engagements. You can't really die. OK, Okay, so he has 1,000 gold. Is he gonna pick something up? He's gonna get an urn. Okay. And max branches. Oh, he was a bit late in helping his ember though, because he spent too much time in the base. Alright, so he does max his heal before the shield. I'm a bit curious, as I think the shield is a lot better. The mana cost doesn't increase by that much. I think it's only 5 a level. And the cooldown gets really good, and the damage block is really good too. The heal like kills yourself a lot faster. I think it's what?
Radiant have fortified their towers.
150 damage at level 4. Oh, he actually uses his heal on the wagon. I didn't know you could do that.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Dire's middle tower is being attacked.
All right, what's the next item?
Illusion. Dire's middle tower taking damage.
The Abaddon's TPing into the gank. That's interesting. He is being really good about having a TP in his inventory at all times. And the way he manages his mana is also really good. I said before that the clarities lasted him until 9 minutes. And this way, like... he's gonna shield Abaddon. Gonna heal him. Heal him again. Nice. He's out of mana. I think he should back off. Yeah. Oh, they're both dead. Oh, really nice taking them the hook. But it is to no avail. The Pudge actually could have killed him if he stuck on it. Oh, he's still gonna go down here. Let's see if he manages to deny himself. Really nicely played. That's something you can always do as Abaddon. And I guess the max level of heal really makes that a lot easier. But if you're low, just remember that the self-damage is always going to be 150. There's no reduction on it. So if you do have less than 150 HP, you can coil something and deny yourself. But yeah, as I was saying before, his mana management is really nice. Something that supports don't really do is, well, sometimes they'll TP into a lane and not have enough mana to do anything. And the way this Abaddon manages his mana, if he TPs into a lane, he's always going to have a shield or a heal. So that's really nicely played. And he is rotating to help his Witch Doctor. Unfortunate missing of the taunt. This shield himself, that's interesting. I guess he's going for the burst damage. I do think he's a bit out of position here. He does have his ulti, so it's pretty fine. Alright, so he did upgrade his branches into a magic wand, and he does have 600 gold. I'm a bit surprised that he isn't helping warding at all. I do think Witch Doctor scales a lot better than Abaddon with items. But maybe his greedy playstyle is gonna pay off. That's pretty good too. I was gonna call him out earlier for pulling without dropping his tranquil boots. But he does know to drop his tranquils when he's last hitting. He's playing relatively dangerously. and he's actually saving the heal for the last hit. Oh, this raping is dead as hell. Oh, nice stampede to get him out. Something that this Abaddon is always doing is when he doesn't need the shield on an ally, he's going to shield himself and then heal someone else. That way you won't lose any HP when you heal someone, because the shield does tank the self damage. Alright, we'll see what item he goes for next. Oh, he actually bought wards, so he is helping buy wards. That's pretty good. I'm just gonna guess he really wants his like core items, in this case being Tranquil Urn, and then he's gonna help ward. I'm gonna guess that he's gonna stop buying items from now on. Maybe he'll get something like a Yule's or a Force Staff, but otherwise he's gonna buy all the wards. I'm a bit surprised he's not staying closer to his Ember Spirit. Though Ember Spirit is sort of a carry that doesn't need to be defended as much because he's so mobile. He's gonna pull through here. And he doesn't use his heal, so he is saving his mana. TP on cooldown, can't do anything for this. That's something you should really watch, especially as a defensive support. You don't want to TP into places that you don't have to, because you're going to put your TP on cooldown. And if you do TP into somewhere that you sort of shouldn't, you should probably try to hide yourself so you don't give away that you don't have a TP. Dire's middle tower is being attacked.
Dire's middle tower taking damage.
I do have to say this Abaddon is taking a lot more form than I thought he would be. Radiant's top tower is under siege. He has 25 last hits at 19 minutes. It's actually not too bad, since a lot of those are from pulls. So I guess it's acceptable. He is gonna go for a 4 staff.
Oh, a lucky find. Thanks.
I'm not gonna fast forward through these like sort of boring parts, because I want to be able to go through the whole replay. This is sort of... I'm aiming to just sort of simulate as if you would watch a replay by yourself. But I'm just gonna, like, commentate things I notice. Okay, so using the shield. I'll just keep an urn charge on the hero who has a blink dagger. Yeah, as I was saying before, I kind of want to make this as close to watching your replay yourself as possible. Just think of it like a replay that you watch for learning, but I'm helping point out things that you might have missed. I know watching replays by yourself to improve can be super boring, but it really does help you improve, especially if you want to learn a specific hero. It really helps to see what other people do, because they might know some like things to make you a bit more efficient, or just some really key aspects of the gameplay that you might miss otherwise. Obviously, you don't have to follow the like Dotabuff top 100 players. You don't want to just copy paste their builds, because there's a chance that they're wrong, and you sort of want to think out builds yourself. That's part of the experience of playing Dota. You don't want to just mindlessly copy people without knowing why they're doing it. Okay, so I'm expecting Abaddon to sort of group up with his team a little bit more. He's mostly been pulling and farming jungle, and he's sort of rotating late to the fights. He's never at the start. He has been with his team in a few ganks, but see, his team is doing a Roshan here without him. This is okay, since so that's a bad 4 stat. It's okay, since they're gonna get it anyway. He's going for the last hit.
Have rejected Roshan's petition to continue living peacefully.
Gold for my chest.
Okay, so now he's picked up his 4 staff. This sort of 4 position Abaddon, I think, can be effective. It's just that Witch Doctor is such a good support to put farm on with his Agnims. And he's separated from his team again. But he is going to place a deep ward, so that's pretty good. Oh, it's Pudge. And he's just scared to fight him. Ooh, close hook. This is something you can do as Abaddon, which is pretty cool, I think. So, this Abaddon is playing pretty well. You're sort of in the jungle, and since you're in Abaddon, you're really hard to kill. So you can sort of play aggressively like this and put pressure on the enemy team. Oh, that's a bad missed combo. Oh, and he gets double stun with his Conquest. A shield to disrupt the stun. And heal while you're in ulti, which is pretty good. That's something you should do. When you're ulted, you should try to heal someone, because the self-damage will actually heal you in your ulti. Oh god. The jukes. Ah, he's dead. Not yourself. It was a good effort. He didn't, he TP'd a bit too early when he was still in vision. I think maybe if he TP'd when he was out of vision, he might have made it.
Radiant's top tower is under siege.
It's good that he shields the Pudge ultimate, as that stun is the most, it's the longest stun they have.
Quite a spree.
So it's probably good to hold the shield for that.
Radiant's towers are fortified. Do as you please with that information.
The Abaddon shield will take off pretty much every buff in this game. I don't think there's a single buff in this game that the shield doesn't take off.
Radiant's middle tower is being attacked.
Besides the shrapnel slow, but that's AoE, so as long as you're standing in it, you're gonna get slowed. Alright, so I think this Sobe Mats is gonna be a Yule Scepter. It's pretty nice. This Abaddon is not gonna have any mana problems. He can spam his heal and shield pretty well. I do know that Abaddon is the top win rate hero throughout every game of Dota 2. It's something like 57%. And yet, no one seems to want to play him. Maybe because he's boring. He doesn't heal the bear. That's an interesting choice. And his positioning is sort of strange. She shields the bear now. Alright, unfortunately for this first episode, Abaddon is a very boring hero. Yeah, it is gonna be a Yule Scepter. And he does take passive over stats. That's probably the correct choice. You do see some Abaddon's healing stats, but I think the passive is worth it. Your shield and heal are obviously a lot better than your passive, but it's still pretty nice to help your team just chase and do stuff. Do more damage to targets. Alright. Save this shield for the stun. And he's gonna run into the sniper. I think this is a really good choice. Since you have your ultimate, you shouldn't be afraid of like dying like most supports in fights. And you can do this sort of thing where you run into the back line and make it really annoying for people to do things in fights. You're kind of like a, I want to say like a clockwork or something, where you can sort of disrupt team fights by just going into the back line. So if he just constantly hits the sniper is gonna have his DPS reduced, and he's gonna feel really like unsafe in fights. He's not gonna be able to do much. He's gonna spend most of his time running instead of hitting things. And you don't really wanna be hitting an Abaddon for the duration of a team fight. It's gonna take like 3 or 4 seconds for him to get down to his ult threshold, then you have to deal with the 3 seconds of ulti, or 4 seconds of ulti, and then you have to kill him afterwards again. It's just a huge annoyance. So what he did there was really nice. You don't want to just stay in the back all the time. You do sort of want to stay in the back for the initial like barrage. You don't want to be initiated at the same time as your other heroes like that, because then you won't be able to shield them or heal them. But running into the back line is pretty nice. I am curious to see if he ever gets dagger on his on the hero. I'm actually gonna go check his Dotabuff games right now and see what items he goes. Looks like he goes for Tranquils, Urn, and then Yules and Ghost. I'm missing Ghost just depending on what sort of heroes he's against. But it looks like this item build is pretty standard. He doesn't get Force every game, but he usually gets Tranquils, Urn, and Yules. I will say that that's a really good core choice of items. And look at this, because he's an Abaddon, he can play like this. Most other supports, they would be super scared to be just standing over here trying to contest the Wraith King for farm. Like, he's the enemy carry, or he's not the enemy carry, he's like the enemy support who's like transitioning to carry, but still really scary for most supports at this point in the game to deal with. This Abaddon is just playing really aggressively, applying pressure. And he's all by himself too. The enemy team doesn't see where the rest of his team is, so this is just a really good play by him. He's actually limiting half the enemy jungle and the bottom lane of farm by himself as a support Abaddon. And this is just like him being a good player and the way the hero works. Like, you're just so hard to kill, most people are not gonna bother. Or they're kind of scared of your team being near. Because you can't really burst them down, so his team's gonna have time to react always. But they do force him out, finally. I guess they saw the team was on the map after they got Roshan. And he is gonna pick up his ghouls. I'm just gonna take a quick look at the net worth. So he's farming pretty well. And we see a team fighter gonna break out here. Gonna heal the bear first. Oh, that ulti was cancelled. That's unfortunate. Alright, one thing that I forgot to mention is that when you're, like, trying to save a really low HP target, unless they're being hurt by something that you can debuff by with your shield, like, you're supposed to have the bear outside the pit. Unless you really need to debuff them, healing is generally better. It's more HP, and it's longer cast range and faster cast time. So the shield is, the heal is just faster and makes saving a lot easier. It's not even about the Aegis. Alright, he's gonna pick up his ghouls here. This Abaddon has generally been really good about saving his shield. Gonna go straight for the sniper. He's also being really good about keeping tabs on who's being focused. I'm just gonna guess that this is because he's with a stack. Wow, he's going balls deep without his ultimate. Radiant's middle tower is taking damage. Radiant's middle tower is being attacked. Radiant's structures are fortified. Dire's top tower is being attacked. Oh, I think he's dead here. Radiant's that's a bit too deep. You can't really play like a Abaddon when you don't have your ultimate. I think his team's gonna lose a fight here because he's not alive. We'll see though. He did buy back and he's slowly running, but I think it's gonna be too late. Oh, never mind. Wow, that Ember Spirit was locked in. Dire's top tower is under siege. Death comes with a battle axe. Alright, so this game is pretty much over. I do try to pick a game that's, when I look at the Dota buff, it looks sort of even. So just based on the score and how the XP and gold graphs look. So hopefully most of these games I'm going to do are going to end up pretty easy to learn from, since I think even games are the best for replays. Obviously sometimes it's nice to look at games when you're winning by a lot or losing by a lot. But just for learning the hero, I think even games, because they put you in all sorts of situations. Summer has brown boots and double battle fury, double crit. This is not the item built to go, by the way. I am an Ember Picker, and this build is not so good. But yeah, anything else I want to mention? Let's see. Yeah, I'm gonna do, I think maybe one of these every 2 or 3 days. I could do one every day, but I do have classes now, so I'm gonna be sort of busy. We'll see. Let me know if you guys actually like enjoyed this kind of stuff. I know Abaddon is like super boring as a hero, but there are people who want to learn him, so I'm just gonna do every hero like this. And if you guys didn't like this, I'm just not gonna do A to Z. Or maybe I will. I'm actually gonna watch replays regardless, so I might as well just record them anyway. I think this is a pretty good way to learn all the heroes, and especially how to improve your gameplay. Because even if you don't care about learning the heroes, it's good to know what the other heroes do to play well. Like that, I forget who said this, but like the best way to learn a hero is remember the last time someone owned you with that hero and then do what they did. So I'm just taking that principle and applying it here to these videos. Alright, so we're just gonna watch the rest of this game. I'm pretty much done analyzing, commentating, whatever you want to call it. So let me know what you guys thought in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys next time. I'll just let the video play out if you want to watch the rest of the game.
Bottom barracks has fallen. Radiant's middle tower is being attacked. Radiant has lost their top tower. Radiant's middle tower is taking damage. Radiant's top barracks has fallen. The Dire have earned mega creeps.